Today we're going to take a deeper look at Microsoft Planner, a new experience in Office 365 to organize work, manage and assign tasks, and collaborate within your teams. We're going to go hands-on and show you how to use Planner, including integrated experiences across Office 365, and we'll take a look at what's in store in the coming months. By Sajan from the Office 365 team. Welcome. So Sajan, Planner is the newest addition to Office 365, but what can people expect from this experience?
Thank you, Jeremy. Planner offers you a simple and visual way to organize teamwork. Now, there are different ways you all get work done. And they're like, until recently, we have had solutions on the two opposite ends of the spectrum. So on one hand, we had like, you have individual work, and we have tools like Wunderlist that you can use to manage your task list. Mm-hmm. And on the other hand, we have project and portfolio management solution, like a product is called Project Online, that you can use to manage projects that require scheduling, prioritization, resource management, timesheet, and even integration with line of business system.
Okay.
And now, Planner is something that we always felt there was a gap in the middle, and that's where Planner fits in. So you can use it to work with your ad hoc teams. For example, let's say you work in IT. You can use it to manage events, user training. And likewise, you can, like folks in different parts of the company can use it too for a variety of team projects.
Right, so this is really how work gets done, but can you give us a look and show us what that looks like?
Sure. So first of all, once you come to Office 365, you can go to the app launcher and you can see the Planner icon here. You click on that and we'll be right into the Planner experience. And what I'm going to do, Jeremy, right now, first let me start and show you how you can create a new plan.
Okay.
So I'm going to click on New Plan. And let's say we work in IT and we are in the process of rolling out Office 365 to one of the branch offices. So I'm going to create a plan called Office 365 Rollout. In this case, I want to make sure that only folks who are invited can see this.
Okay.
You can add a description and then you can click on Create Plan. So now my plan is created. And first of all, you can see that we are in this what we call as a board view. Mm-hmm. And here you can start with by creating different buckets.
And the buckets are the groupings of tasks, right?
Yes, exactly. Okay. So let's say in this case, we want to have a set of tasks which are related to communications.
Right.
So we can create that. Second, you can think, let's say we have to find some champions.
Our early adopters.
Exactly. So which can help you, to drive success. And third, let's say we'll have a set of tasks related to governance of the rollout.
Right, so we can report against how we're doing.
Exactly. Okay. Now, I can also go ahead and create some to-dos. Like in this case, let's say I'll just first create a task called assign licenses, and I can add the task. Mm-hmm. You can click on that. And you can go into more details for that task.
Okay.
Like to start with, let's say here you can have like, start date, due date. Let's say we want this thing to be done by June 24th.
Okay.
I can assign this task to somebody. In this case, I'm going to pick you, Jeremy, so let me look for you, and here you are. So now I've picked you as a person who's going to work on this.
Okay.
You can enter a description. So I'll say assign licenses to all users.
Okay.
Next, you can go, if you have a document, you can attach that. Mm-hmm. You can also put a link. What I really like here is that not only can you create a task, you can also create a checklist. So let's say I give this task to you. You think of some subtasks that should be part of this. You can capture those here in the checklist. Like, you can say that validate user is permanent employee. I'm just making up, a list.
Right.
And you can go on, you can create more. So you can also enter a comment. So there's a very social experience. And with that, that's how you can assign a task and you can get started.
Okay, so if we switch over to my PC, then I should have this task. And I can see that my tasks have gone from 11 previously to 12. So if I look at mine, I can see that my assigned licenses, there we are at the bottom. We have all of the information that you just added in there, Sajan.
Yep.
And I'm going to add some more items because I know I need to download the PowerShell module to do, because I'm going to script all of my license assignments. And we'll also figure out which users we want to actually assign. So select users, we'll say.
Yep.
And then after that, I can say, well, I've validated who's a permanent employee, for example, and I've already downloaded my PowerShell module, so I've already gotten started. So the nice thing is here, once I've made those two different things, changes to my checklist, I can actually move that into in progress just by a simple drag and drop. And if I scroll back up to the top of the page, now it's in my in-progress task that I've got here in my all-task list. And this is really across all of my plans that I'm working on.
Exactly.
So what else can we do now? Once we've got a simple project created, let's move on to a larger project that already has been populated, that's kind of midstream, to show really the power of what we can do with Planner.
Sure. For that, Jeremy, I'm going to take you to this Planner Hub.
Mm-hmm.
So once you come to Planner Hub, you can see all the plans that you're part of.
Okay.
Now, let's say here in this case, we're going to talk about dive deep into Tech Summit. I'll click here. First, I'll mark that as a favorite. So next time when I come here, I can see all my favorite plans.
Okay.
Now, here you can say color-wise, like yellow means these tasks have not been started. Red is late, blue is in progress, and green is completed.
Okay.
So let's click on this. We can dive in and see what's going on with this plan. So once you come in, you'll always start with a board view. And first thing is that if I were to scroll to the right, you can see that there are three different ways you can organize all the tasks that you have.
Mm-hmm.
So buckets is one view that we have, which we already talked about.
Right.
Now, next we can go, let's say I click on assign to. And very quickly you can say that the whole experience got rearranged in terms of the different folks that are on the team. And you can easily go and see that who is working on what.
Okay.
And what tasks they are on, what type of documents they're working on, you can see that. The third thing you have here is like, you can go ahead and click on progress. Now, you essentially get to see your task as not started, in progress, and completed. Now, Jeremy, like last week, I had a chance to speak with our friend Garth, and he's on vacation now. And I know that he's already done with this task. So I can go ahead here and I mark that as completed.
Okay.
So that's how, as a team, we can all stay up to date and we will know what's going on.
So it's not statically assigned to just the person that the task was assigned to. That way, we can very fluidly be able to do things like this.
Exactly.
Okay.
I mean, everything is very transparent. The whole team can collaborate on that.
Right, right.
Now, let's say in this case, I want to see that what is the status of everything. You know, it's more like a report.
Okay.
You click on charts, and you'll see an experience where you'll see all the tasks that are there. And right in the middle, you can see that all the tasks that are either work in progress or, you know, they are not completed yet.
Mm-hmm.
Now I see here, Anne has some, I see a red mark here, which means this task is running late.
Right.
So I can click on this, and you notice that on the right side, the whole list got filtered. So I'm looking at Anne's task now, and I know this task is, you know, something that we are running late with.
Okay.
So and you can, that's how we can go and interact with. Now, the other thing is that Planner is built on top of Office 365 groups.
Right.
So as a result, it's like integrates out of box, you know, with a lot of other capabilities we have in 365.
Yep.
Like you can see here, we have a notebook. And we have other features, you know, conversations, calendar, and a whole lot of other features.
Mm-hmm.
So that's how, you know, you get the best of the whole 365 that comes with Planner. And now, if I were to click on conversations, so you'll come and you'll see your conversations experience. Like here, I'm seeing my plan Tech Summit.
Mm-hmm.
And you can go ahead and, you know, you can respond and, you know, you can like something. Let's say this comment I wrote, I can like. And so those are type of experience we can have.
Okay.
So if I'll click here, you can see we have a good dialogue going on. You know, I asked you, send me a template, and I still didn't get template. So I'm going to tell you that, okay, please send it soon so that I can get our work done. And that's how we can sort of collaborate on this.
Right, so if we move back to my machine, then we'll be able to see the comment stream that we have on that particular task. So I'm just going to go back into my Planner Hub, and I'll be able to see all the things that I've pinned as well to the top as favorites, and there we see the Tech Summit. And if I go into that task that you had, in this case it was the building the reports for the governance side of that specific event, and then scroll down, we'll be able to see the please send it soon task that you just sent to me. So. Very tight, great integration across Office 365 groups. If you want more information on groups, of course, we covered that on an earlier show with Christoph Fiesinger a few weeks back. Now, beyond all of this stuff, it's really great to see this from a planning and team workforce management perspective, but what's coming to Planner in the upcoming months?
There's a lot going on at our end. So I'll talk about the key things that we're working on.
Mm-hmm.
First, we're working on external user access so that you can collaborate with tasks with folks who don't work for your company.
Okay.
That's one. Second thing is that one of the requests we have from many users is that the ability to assign a task to multiple users, that's second.
Mm-hmm.
And third, we are working on a Windows Universal app, as well as native apps for iOS and Android. So those are some of the top things that we are working on.
Really great, and really looking forward to seeing those changes. So if I'm new to Planner, where do I get started?
I think it's very simple. Like we're in the process of rolling it out. So I would say, go and log into Office 365, go to the app launcher, If it has been provisioned, you should be able to see Planner right there. And then you can get, you know, give it a try and let us know how, you know, if you have any feedback on that.
And be sure to keep giving us your feedback, because we've set up a user voice specifically for that as we're just rolling out Planner now. And don't forget to keep checking back to Microsoft Mechanics for the latest tech updates. That's about all the time we have for today's show. Thanks for watching, and goodbye for now.